Okay, let's see what we can't do about getting this out drive off here. I'm gonna start by disconnecting the power tilt. I'm gonna start by hitting it with a little PB blaster. Help, maybe it won't. Either way, there we did. This here's a pin that goes all the way through. So maybe that'll make it easier. We don't have to take the front loose to get it off. Work. Very careful with this punch so I don't mess up that pin. If I had a wooden dowel, I'd use that, but I don't. Very careful. Plastic washer. Can you tell it's my first time? Yes, need to go ahead and get all that oil drained out of it. Where the heck is my plug? There's the oil plug. That looks kind of ugly, doesn't it? I don't know what color it went in, but I know what color it's coming out. The old boat was taken pretty good care of, so. A little surprised to see that, honestly. Open this up. here's the dipstick. That should help it run a little better. We'll take out what they call the fill plug. I guess it is, but and you may notice I'm using an impact driver instead of a screwdriver. That's just in case it gets ugly with me, I can help it some. But those came out okay. This is brilliant. Probably a good idea to move that plug before you start that process. Magnet on this plug here. Fortunately, it looks pretty clean. In fact, it looks really clean. Unlike that black oil. That drain a minute while we bust the 6 bolts loose that hold it together. Let that finish draining. Back these off a little more. Crack that case loose, but I don't want it to fall off before we start boogering up threads and breaking cases and whatnot. Okay, that's loose. Water dripping out from in between. It should have water in that. Now we busted the case. From the exhaust bellow. I've heard people bad-mouthing these OMC outdrives. But it's certainly unwarranted. They it doesn't matter what these OMC outdrives, you can still get parts for them. And they ain't a motor on the planet. It's easier to replace that impeller. Take these three bolts off here, right to it. Three bolts on the impeller housing, one little tube, and pops right out. You don't have to split that lower like you do most. Most brilliant design I've ever seen. Supposed to replace that every year. At least that's what they want you to do. Most of us don't. But when you set up like that, there's no reason not to, really. All right, that's good enough. Go ahead and pull this one together. I don't know why I went down there without the screwdriver. I didn't. All right. That should stop the bleeding there. That was dripping now, just water. And since I'm an old man, I'm going to use this car here to catch that when it falls, so I don't bang up threads on them studs. By letting it drop and just hang on that shaft, I'm going to skip that part. Washers out of there. I ain't gonna argue with them too long. Get my little baby screwdriver. Help them out of there. Plan is to snatch this thing off here and lay it on that little buggy without dropping it. I have no idea how it's actually gonna go. Alright. I don't see the washer, so I'll get it in a minute, I guess. I don't remember. This video will remind me as I'm uploading it, which I will be doing in a few minutes. Proper way is to stick that screwdriver through it so it don't get away from me. There it is. Alright. Move all the crap. See what happens. This one cracked loose pretty easy. drive shaft may be stuck in there a little bit. I'm going to help it a little. Let's see if this, I'm just about destroying anything. There we go. Theoretically speaking, that should do it. Hold on, baby. I'm going to lay you down here because I ain't going to try and manhandle it. Come on now. There you go. Not gonna lie, that worked better than I thought. Let's move this out of the way now. All right, that looks in pretty good shape. Probably been a while since the U joints greased, but they're nice and tight. I don't see no water in there where there shouldn't be. Got those hanging on the hoses. Probably ought to be real careful with that. Got all the ground wires on there like they should be to keep the electrolysis problem down. Well, little scum in there, but it looks pretty good. Bearing looks good, it's plenty greased. Bellows looks good. Very good. All right, that's all we're doing with that for right now. Getting ready to pull that motor. Stay tuned for that. That ought to be a ruckus.